When you vote in the August primary election, your ballot will look different. And behind the scenes, the machines Pierce County Elections will use will drastically change how your ballot is counted. Matt Samsel has more.
After more than 20 years with outdated digital scanners, Pierce County Elections just switched to Clear Ballot.
It's going to save time. It's adding more transparency, better quality control, and I think it's better for the public.
And of course, the biggest change is going to be the oval.
At an open house, the public was invited to tour the election center, learning about all the stages your ballot must go through, and under the new system, what was done before and how it will be different now. The biggest change for voters is no longer needing to connect the arrow.
But instead of connecting the arrow, they're going to be asked to make a mark or fill in an oval. Same kind of stuff that you did in elementary school, in middle school.
This is signed by everyone who touches it, including myself. I take this document, I put it in the scanner, hit green for go. This will let the system know that I'm gonna start box 147. Then I can take my ballots, I can stick them in the scanner, and I hit green for go.
The scanners are expected to reduce unreadable ballots by 90%. In the 2016 general election, Pierce County Elections had to remake 58,000 ballots by hand because the old tabulation machines couldn't interpret some markings.
With optical scan, we're going to be taking an image of the entire ballot and then reviewing the entire ballot, including all of the marks that are outside of the target area, which voters frequently make.
Yeah, I think the ability to make sure that you can correct the ballot very quickly using this process as opposed to the previous method that was quite time intensive.
Pierce County saved for 5 years to buy the new system, costing $790,000. Matt Samsel, Pierce County Talks.
The Pierce County Auditor's Office chose the company Clear Ballot for the new election system, which includes state-of-the-art equipment, software, licensing, and installation. Joining me now to talk about it is Julie Anderson, Pierce County Auditor, and Damon Townsend, the Pierce County Elections Supervisor. Thanks for being here.
Thanks, Megan.
Thank you.
Tell me, what does going to this new election system mean for the voter?
Well, not too much, actually. The look and feel of the ballot is going to change a little bit, but it's going to look an awful like those grade school tests that you would take, scholastic testing, fill in the bubble. So it's going to be pretty intuitive. It still looks like a ballot. You're still going to see the same elected officials. So not too much of a change for voters. You're not changing state laws. You're still going to get your ballot 18 days in advance. You're still going to return it by mail or one of our convenient drop boxes. So it's not too big of a change for them. Big changes for us.
Good. Damon, you have an example of an old and a new ballot. What are some of the things that's the noticeable differences?
Yeah, you'll notice that the ballot itself is very similar. We have here our older ballot with the connect the arrow and our newer ballot with the connect or fill in the oval. We tried to keep the look and feel as close so the voters would have the same experience, but they'll just be marking their ballot a little bit differently. They can still use a pen. They won't be drawing a straight line to connect an arrow, which is not as intuitive as fill in the bubble. And the instructions are still clearly on the ballot, and you're going to see that they're going to come to you just like they did before in the mail 18 days before the election.
Good. I remember with older ballots, we used to have rules about what color of pen we could use, things like that. Are there other noticeable changes for voters in that way?
So our instructions are very simple. It says use a pen to fill in the bubble next to the choice that you want to make. You can still use any marking device you use, but we do prefer a pen. It's the cleanest and it works best. No particular colors.
Yeah.
Just use a pen.
No confusion about pen, pencil, blue, mm-hmm. black.
Yes.
Don't worry about it.
Changing the election system also means going to new tabulation machines. And that's the biggest thing that you're kind of referring to, the big changes on your end. What does that new system mean on yours?
Well, first of all, the footprint of our equipment has shrunk incredibly. The tabulation system that we used to have, ka-chunk, 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 they were great workhorses in the time, but they were as big as like a small, like a snowmobile big. The footprint now is just like a desktop scanner much like you'd have in a home office. Mm-hmm. So we've really shrunk our footprint, which is good. We needed this space.
And we were allowed to remove the hearing protection requirements that were required for our old machines. So it's much quieter in there, so we can actually converse with our workers when we're running ballots.
Right.
And how does the new tabulation system, how do they work?
Well, the biggest difference is we're talking about a digital system, and the old system was an optical scan. So you would, the old system, the ballots would run through, and an electric eye, if you will, would be looking for a mark in a very small field. You mm-hmm. really had to hit that target connecting the arrow there. But with a digital scan, you're going to take a picture of the entire ballot, and that has amazing benefits for us and for voters, I think, too.
Yes. With the old system, it only would look in the target area itself, where this system, as Julie said, will take a picture of the entire ballot, and we can look at that on a screen, the original image, and see the entire ballot when we're having to make any resolutions to that. If there's a voter correction or if there's a smudge or anything like that, we can see the whole ballot, where the old system was only looking at a mark.
I mean, the old system had to be, your ballot had to be perfect. Mm-hmm. And if it wasn't perfect, we had to make it perfect through what we call a remake process, which would mean pulling the exact same ballot, one of like 200 types, out of the library and having employees, two at a time, marking the ballot perfectly when the voter didn't, or if the voter had oatmeal on the ballot. This new system is much more robust, and voters can make mistakes, and we're not going to have to remake the ballot. We'll have a digital image of the entire thing. Workers can view it, and they can resolve issues according to the Washington State Voter Intent Book. So it's not willy-nilly. Mm-hmm. It's something that's statewide and uniform all over the state.
Remakes and audits are part of this business. How does this new system help you with that?
Yeah.
So this new system, because it takes a whole digital image of the ballot, has some very unique features that allow us to, after the election has started the tabulation process, after 8 o'clock on election night, this system will actually pull from that database of images the most and least confident marks. Mm-hmm. So in the past, we did not see anything like that until there was a physical recount, where we'd have to pull the ballots out of the boxes and a human would look at that. And if there was a light mark or a marginal mark that the machine may not have completely picked up, we wouldn't see that until that recount mm-hmm. process. Where with this system, it will show you a threshold of 100 of the least confident marks. And we can look at those during the process mm-hmm. and actually resolve them before we certify an election.
Another neat thing is that the political party observers or just regular citizens can watch us while we're doing that through the viewing window as operators are looking at like least confident marks and making decisions about voter intent. They'll actually see what's on the screen and the decisions that get made right along with us. So a lot of transparency mm-hmm. and a great audit trail.
Technology can sometimes make people nervous or uncomfortable. Do you feel like this technology is helping with the integrity of local elections?
Well, absolutely. The auditability of the ballots and the system is like the most exciting thing. Mm-hmm. Being able to review thousands and thousands of ballots and do random audits mm-hmm. and have supervisory review and political party observer review is fantastic. But Damon, talk about the security and how protected we are.
Yeah, the one thing was very fortunate for us is when we procured the new system, we had the opportunity to rebuild our election center. So we took the opportunity to make it even more transparent about how secure our network is. The election system never touches the internet. It's not ever going to be connected to any outside network. And to ensure that, we put our network wires in a visible rack around the room. So if you come to our election center, come down mm-hmm. our hallway, look in our viewing windows, you can see that that system goes from scan station to server and nowhere else.
And it's also protected from any kind of Wi-Fi intrusion. Mm-hmm. People also want think, oh, well, the wires are all good, but what about hacking or penetrating with Wi-Fi?
Yeah, every one of the scan station machines, the servers, all wireless Bluetooth capability is turned off from the factory when they're sent to us. The Secretary of State's office comes in when we did our acceptance test and verified that all those machines are hardened. There's no wireless capabilities in that building, in that room, so. Yeah.
Very good. How did you pay for the system?
Well, we had a piggy bank, just the way you want to buy a car, and we paid with cash. Seriously, we've established a fund about 5 years ago, and the county council and county executive were very supportive, and we started literally putting in small fees that we charged to all of the jurisdictions per election, and slowly building it up over time, and we were able to pay for the entire system that way. It's called an election equipment replacement fund, and it worked. It did its job.
As we get close to the election and people start receiving their primary ballot and the general election ballot, and they see it and they have questions, what are some of the ways that you plan to kind of answer those questions for people? How can they reach out to you?
Well, in the ballot itself, we include information in an insert. There's information on how to mark your ballot. There's information about how this is a primary election. Part of our county actually has a partisan office on this election, so there's some special rules involved there. Also, our voters' pamphlets will be mailed out shortly. The voters' pamphlet has a lot of information in it. It tells you where to go to vote, where you can go for a ballot drop box. We have a couple of new boxes that we've got installed this year, so there's a couple of new ones out there for people. They can always give us a phone call at 253-798-VOTE, and our friendly staff will talk to people. And our website is piercecountyelections.org, and there's a ton of useful information on our website.
They could also download the mobile app, Civic Pierce County, and it's free and for Android and Apple. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Are there any important dates that people should know, any deadlines if they want to register still that they should keep in mind as we get to close?
Thanks for asking. We like it when people pay attention to deadlines. So if you are a new voter to Washington State, came from California, Arizona, whatever, the in-person deadline for those new voters is July 24th for this upcoming August 1st primary. If you are doing transfers, like if you're one of those people that's moving from King County into Pierce County, it's July 3rd for the August 1st primary.
Very good. Great information today. Thank you for coming.
Yeah.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
That wraps up this edition of Pierce County Talks. You can watch this program online or on our mobile app at piercecountytv.org. I'm Megan Hutton. Thanks for watching.